There's a few advanced registry tweaks in Windows that have definitely made my life easier that I figured I'd talk about. I've got 7 of them to be exact. All of them are obviously optional, but still at least good to know about. And of course, remember, anytime you're messing with the registry, you gotta be careful. It's always a good idea to make a backup first. Starting out with some user interface stuff, these 3 settings are all gonna be in the same location, which is under HKEY_CURRENT_USER, Control Panel, and then Desktop. The first one to look at is called MenuShowDelay, and this is the delay in milliseconds that any expandable window in the context menu will take before it shows. The default is 400 milliseconds, but sometimes that seems a bit slow. So I personally put it down to 100 milliseconds, which is a pretty good amount, I think. You could set it down to literally 0, which would be instant, but I probably wouldn't recommend that because in that case, even scrolling past one of the menus would make them all flicker and appear and kind of be annoying. So maybe set it to at least something a little bit higher, but really it's a personal preference thing. And you will have to either restart Explorer or log out and log back in for it to take effect. Next up, there's these two, which I'm just gonna count as one, which are DragHeight and DragWidth. These values set the number of pixels that you need to click and then hold and drag the mouse before that thing actually registers as moving. So this includes clicking and dragging a file to move it in File Explorer, or even clicking and dragging highlighted text, and also clicking and dragging window title bars to move the window itself. The default value is just 4, and on higher DPI screens, like in my case, it's a 4K 27-inch monitor, that means that that's not very far at all and can lead to a lot of accidental moves. A lot of times if I click a window and it's maximized, doing a drag move actually unmaximizes it, so I end up doing that a lot accidentally. And also sometimes you might mean to just click something and then it starts dragging and doesn't do what you want. So I personally set this to 30 and I find that to be a pretty good amount. Now for you, the best setting is gonna really depend on like your monitor and the scaling you have on Windows. In my case, where Windows is set to 150% scaling, 30 pixels is just about the amount where it's the distance between 2 files in the details list view of File Explorer. So I probably wouldn't want it to be more than that because then it makes it really annoying to maybe drag something into another thing. But again, you could play around with it. And again, like all of these, you're probably gonna have to log out and log back in of Windows to make it take effect. Next, the third option in this location is called DragFromMaximize. This is either an on or off setting, 1 or 0. And when it's set to off or 0, that makes it so you can't click and drag to move a maximized window. So if the window is maximized with the thing at the top right, you're not gonna be able to click and drag it. You would have to first double click, for example, to make it not maximized and then move it. And I personally very often find myself somehow accidentally clicking and dragging a maximized window and then it ends up moving. So I do have it set to 0, but you might not wanna do that. It's a personal preference. Now the rest of the registry settings are at different locations, so I'll obviously say where these are. The next one is at this location under the system key, and the value is called VerboseStatus. And I will try to put all the paths and names of the stuff in the description so you can just kind of copy and paste it. Now, this one might not exist by default. You would have to create it by doing right click, new. And this is another on or off where 1 enables it, 0 disable it. But what it does is basically when you're starting up Windows or shutting down, normally it'll just say starting or shutting down, but with this it'll actually give you a lot more details about exactly what is going on and what is starting up and shutting down in terms of services. So for example, if you find that Windows is slow to shut down and seems like it hangs a lot, you could enable this and just leave it on and be able to get a better idea of maybe what exactly is causing that slowdown. So I just kind of leave it on. There's not really a downside to it. And by the way, I believe all of these are case sensitive, so make sure you spell it right. Next up, this is one that I always add whenever I get a new computer, and that is a tweak that will make it so it hides the stupid web results in the start menu searches. Because I don't know about you, but if I'm searching the start menu, I'm searching something on my computer, not the web. It's so stupid. So you can actually disable this. If you go to this path, you need to create a D word called DisableSearchBoxSuggestions, and then you'll set that value to 1, and then again, log out, log back in, or restart, and then now they won't show up anymore. Next up, here's a couple tweaks that could potentially make your computer start up faster. Now for this one, you might actually have to create this registry key. And by key, I'm talking about the folder looking things on the left. These are keys, the things on the right are values. Anyway, under this path, under Explorer, you might have to actually create the serialize key. And then within that key, you create two new DWORD type values. One of them would be called StartupDelayInMSec, so startup delay in milliseconds. And the other one is gonna be called WaitForIdleState. Now what these do is affects how long Windows waits to launch certain apps. Apparently, it's not really well documented. And from what I've read, Windows by default will basically wait to launch certain programs until it detects that there's some kind of level of CPU activity below a certain threshold to loading other stuff. I don't know, it's really stupid that they artificially delay the startup of Windows, literally. From my understanding, Windows 10 will be affected by the delay one, and Windows 11 will be affected by the idle time one, but there's not really a harm in just adding both. So the state idle one, set that to zero, that disables it, doesn't make Windows wait. And the delay in milliseconds one, you would think you would set this to zero, but apparently zero doesn't work, so just set it to 1 millisecond. And I personally did not find this to make really any difference, but I have a pretty good CPU. But people on Reddit apparently swear by it, or it might only be useful in certain situations, but still, I don't see a problem with it. Finally, here's a tweak in the taskbar. If you ever want to have it show seconds in addition to minutes, you can actually go into this location, and then you would create a new DWORD value called ShowSecondsInSystemClock, and then you would set it to 1 to enable it, or if you ever wanted to disable it, just set it to 0 again. So I hope at least a couple of those will be useful to some of you. Let me know down in the comments if you find any of them useful. And of course, if you enjoyed the video, you know what to do. Absolutely nuke the like button from orbit. We can't leave any of it remaining. It really does help out. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talk about a file in Windows that if you create it, it will cause a permanent blue screen of death. So I will put that link right there you can click on. And if you want to subscribe, I try to make videos about twice a week, Wednesday and Saturday, so it should be worth it. So thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.